Ever since we've had the technology to make it outer space, some strange things have gone on that aren't always easy to explain. Many Americans and Soviet spacecraft have experienced similar problems, and even just last year, two astronauts had to declare an emergency when something went wrong. From landing in a frozen lake, to testimonies of real astronauts, here are strange and mysterious space exploration incidents.
Hey guys, this is American Eye, bringing you another great video.
Number 11, Soyuz 5. A strange series of events occurred during the Soyuz 5 space mission that involved astronauts from a Soviet spacecraft transferred to another spacecraft while in space. It was the first mission of its kind, but it didn't necessarily go as planned. The craft's service module didn't separate, so it entered the atmosphere at high speed. This left the astronaut Boris Volynov hanging in by his restraining straps. The craft he was in was barreling towards Earth at such a fast speed that the atmosphere burned through the module. It luckily corrected its angle of descent before the escape hatch was completely burned through. It would continue to get worse as the parachute lines tangled and the landing rockets failed to deploy. This led to an extremely rough landing for Boris, which caused him to break a few of his teeth. He then ended up in the Caucasus Mountains, where the weather was negative 35 degrees Fahrenheit. Boris then walked a few miles to find some shelter inside a home of a peasant before he was rescued. Number 10. Testimonies of Gordon Cooper. With all the space exploration NASA has done, you'd expect there to be some experience with UFOs. Despite being sworn to secrecy about what they saw, Gordon Cooper, a pilot for the Mercury spacecraft, came forward about his experience with mysterious aircraft, to say the least. In 1957, Gordon was assigned to an experimental aircraft, and while flying around, he says he saw a strange-looking saucer-like craft that wouldn't make a sound while flying. He claims there's no way the Soviet Union or the USA could have possibly possessed the technology to create such a thing. He also states that he was instructed to make lie after lie in order to keep the UFO secret. Once he retired, he confessed there's been countless sightings that have been swept under the rug by the US government, and it's very likely that they actually have an alien spacecraft. We encourage everyone to listen to his testimonies and see what you think. Number 9. Hello from Earth. Sometimes we send things in outer space in hope of communicating with other intelligent life forms around the universe. Hello from Earth is an interstellar radio message that is sent using NASA's Deep Space Station. Will ET ever respond to our text messages or what? If the possible inhabitants of Galaxy 581D contain a radio receiver and ability to read binary code, they will get a series of text messages from Australia. This certainly isn't your average text message, and it'll take 20 years to send this to Galaxy 581D. This is the closest Earth-like planet that we know about, but maybe we should stay away. If there are other aliens on this planet, who knows how advanced they are, and hopefully they won't come to Earth to enslave us. Number 8. Space debris. Over 5,000 chunks of space debris is in outer space, and it's known as space junk. This stuff orbits Earth, and it can travel at speeds at over 17,000 miles an hour. This can include meteoroids or artificial materials that were left in space. In 1996, a French satellite was struck by debris from a rocket and severely damaged it. So what exactly happens when all this stuff falls from the sky? Scientists are waiting to find out what will happen when all this space pollution comes back to haunt us. In April 2016, a large piece of Russian space junk created a bright green light over Southern California and Nevada. Eyewitnesses also captured plenty of videos and photos for you to check out. Number 7. Object X. The Hubble telescope picked up a bizarre finding in 2010 of this X-shaped pattern of debris that was possibly made from a collision of two asteroids. A collision such as this has never been seen before. With the two asteroids traveling at an estimated speed of 11,000 miles per hour, they're both going faster than a bullet shot from a rifle, about 5 times faster to be exact. Imagine looking into the sky and seeing something like this heading straight for Earth. With the extreme speed of collision, it allowed for scientists to witness a one-of-a-kind nucleus. This part measured about 460 feet wide and trailed by dust of the same composition. It originated from the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter, not too far away from us. Number 6. Solar Flare 2001. The Sun unleashed a massive solar flare in April of 2001, which was considered to be the biggest recorded incident of that happening. The explosion unleashed the northwestern limb of the star at an astronomical speed of 7.2 million kilometers or 4.5 million miles an hour. Billions of tons of magnetic gases were released, and we were lucky that the flames weren't aimed at us. It caused power outages in Canada. When a sudden rapid variation of brightness of the sun occurs, it has the ability to alter a few things in our solar system. When a solar flare occurs, it lets off every type of wavelength known in our entire electromagnetic spectrum. X-rays, gamma rays, you name it. For a short period of time, it changed the structure of Earth's electromagnetic field. The energy given off is about 10 million times more powerful than the energy released from a volcanic eruption. During the time of the solar flare, it produced a radio blackout on the sunlit side of the Earth. Number 5. Fast radio bursts. With the increase in space technology, it seems like we're getting closer and closer to making contact. A mysterious phenomenon was noted by scientists in 2007, which only lasted a few milliseconds, but it emitted an immense amount of energy. The astrophysics department at Cornell University has even discussed this as a serious possibility of extraterrestrial civilization. In just a few milliseconds, fast radio bursts emitted more energy than the entire sun during a 24-hour period. No one can seem to truly understand the real origin of these bursts, and some think they're trying to communicate with us. Number 4. Apollo 12. Many of us have heard of the Apollo missions that go to the moon, but whatever happened to our second trip, and why was it so weird in November 1969? And why does Alan Bean get no attention in history? The launch was actually struck by lightning twice, which is extremely rare. The first strike took place after just 30 seconds of liftoff, and it managed to knock three fuel cells offline. This engaged the backup fuel, but the craft was struck by lightning again just 52 seconds after liftoff. Temperature sensors on the outside of the spacecraft were burnt out, and the reaction control system failed for a few moments. Fuel cell power was eventually restored, and the astronauts spent a little extra time in Earth's orbit to make sure it was okay. But hold on, it still gets weird. The crew brought a color television camera with them to the lunar surface on the Apollo flight, but the camera was accidentally destroyed when the pilot accidentally pointed it towards the sun. During splashdown, Alan Bean, the pilot, was struck in the eye by a movie camera and then suffered from a concussion. Number 3. STS-27. One of the biggest cranes ever used by NASA was the Canada arm, which was used in space to deploy and maneuver different payloads. Canada was given the honor to build this for us from NASA, and was modeled after a robot that would load fuel into nuclear reactors. It was able to deploy and reload payloads of 733 pounds at first, then redesigned to control about 10 times that much in the 1990s. The large machine was over 577 feet long when fully extended and weighed about 2 tons. It was one of Canada's big achievements and enjoyed over 30 years of successful missions. But it would also be involved in a space mission that left the spaceship in a critical amount of damage. The space shuttle known as Atlantis had extensive damage to its thermal protection system that utilized aluminum tiles like we see here. The crew tried to see what was wrong by using the Canada arm's camera, but the resolution was extremely poor. This caused the guys back on Earth to think damage was simply lights and shadows. The astronauts knew it was much worse, but were forced to re-enter Earth's atmosphere anyway. Over 700 thermal tiles were either partially melted or damaged in some way, and some considered to be a miracle that everyone landed safely. A similar problem would occur that would be much more devastating than the Columbia launch in 2003. Number 2. Soyuz MS-10. Strange astronaut incidents can occur in modern times as well, and this recent one took place on October 11th in 2018. It was another close call, which could have seriously resulted in some bad news for the USA and Russia, since astronauts of both countries were on board. The crew members included Alexei Ovchinin of Russia and Nick Haig of the USA. A few moments after liftoff, they began to feel weightlessness, and it was discovered that a booster had failed. The main cause for the failure was that there was a deviation from the standard trajectory, and before you know it, the whole mission is over. An emergency is declared at an altitude of 31 miles, and the crew was forced to descend at a 90-degree angle back to the surface. This subjected the crew to 6 or 7 times the amount of gravity on Earth. Being exposed to that much gravity typically has a negative consequence, but luckily they turned out to be okay. It was the first incident of a manned booster accident since 1983.
Hey guys, if you haven't noticed already, we're almost at 1 million subscribers, so remember to smash that subscribe button.
And number 1. Soyuz 23. Possibly one of the coldest splashdowns in history took place in 1976 during the Soviet mission of Soyuz 23. A failed docking attempt at a space station in October of that year forced the cosmonauts to return back to Earth, but not in the way that they had planned. Soyuz 23 came back to Earth just 2 days later, but due to poor weather conditions, they couldn't clearly tell where they were landing. They landed directly in the freezing Lake Tengiz in Kazakhstan, about 8 kilometers away from the shore. Due to a blizzard in the area, the temperatures there reached negative 22 degrees Celsius, but luckily the capsule was designed to withstand water. The main problem was trying to relocate the crew. Rescue efforts had to wait until the morning too. Amphibious vehicles and helicopters were used to drive the capsule to the shore, and it took a total of 9 hours to get them back. They'd also presumed the worst for the astronauts. They didn't even bother opening the capsules until they were back to shore and surprised everyone that they were all alive. It got so cold inside that the interior was actually coated with frost.